next.
It's the feeling that you can't control. I suppose it's like forgetting, losing who you are. And at the same time, something makes you whole. It's like there's some music playing in your ear. And I'm listening.
way, but it's me you need to change. It's time to stop the hiding. It's time to spend all tall. Say, hey, world, I'm different.
And here I am.
Here I am. Let your freak fly, babe. Let your freak fly, fly.
Pour myself a cup of ambition, yawn and stretch and try to come alive. I jump in the shower and the blood starts pumping. Out on the streets, the traffic starts jumping with folks like me on the job from 9 to 5. Get to work!
Live from Radio City Music Hall. It's the American Theater Wing's 63rd Annual Tony Awards, presented by the Broadway League and the American Theater Wing. Stars of stage, screen, and television celebrate Broadway's biggest night as we honor the best and brightest performances and shows. Tonight, we present more music than ever before with fantastic performances from the current season and from theaters around the country, hit shows now playing across America. And now, here's your host, Neil Patrick Harris.
Welcome to the 63rd Annual Tony Awards. I'm Neil, thanks for being here. How about that opening number? That was amazing. Bret Michaels on the Broadway stage. His number gave headbanging a whole new meaning. He's fine. I was told that that was the biggest and the most expensive number in the history of the Tony Awards. And that is why I'm your host tonight. I'm in TV. No, but seriously, and I actually want to go off prompter for a second. I grew up watching the Tonys. I grew up in a small town, South Central New Mexico mountains, and the one time a year that I would have a window into what Broadway was, what theater meant on any big level, was the Tony Awards. So to be now standing here, this stage center at Radio City Music Hall, is kind of blowing my mind. The fact that these people here create this show and do this night after night with 100% commitment, It's shocking, and I'm never not blown away by it. Thank you all coming here at Radio City. You look fetching. And most importantly, for you at home who've decided to spend a couple hours with us, we hope to bring you the best show we can. So now, let's bring on the Constantine Maroulis jokes. I kid because I can. It's truly going to be a really great show. There's amazing stars here tonight, star presence. James Gandolfini is here. Anne Hathaway is here. Will Ferrell is here. Right? And they have got some very important after parties to get to, so let's not keep them waiting. They're in the movies. Our first presenter is a two-time Academy Award-winning actress. It's been 46 years since she was last seen on Broadway, so we can look forward to her return in 2055 in Blithe Spirit. Please welcome a Tony nominee tonight, the incredible Jane Fonda.
What an opening. Five magnificent actors have been singled out for work that has been true to the playwright, to their fellow actors, and ultimately to themselves. Their ability to collaborate while trusting their instincts has created startling performances that will be remembered long after this ceremony is over. The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actor in a Play are John Glover in Waiting for Godot, Zach Grenier in 33 Variations, Steve Stephen Mangan, The Norman Conquest. Paul Ritter and The Norman Conquest. And Roger Robinson and Joe Turner's Come and Gone. And the winner, the American Theater Wing's Tony, goes to Roger Robinson, Joe Turner's Come and Gone.
Tonight, Roger Robinson takes home his first Tony Award.
I did.
What'd you think about that?
No. I was there.
Wow. It has taken me 46 years to come from that seat up these steps to this microphone. I promised LaTanya Richardson Jackson I wouldn't cry. I have a lot of people to thank, and I'm going to thank them now. My mother, who is 98 years old in Washington, Bellevue, Washington, who encouraged me and raised 7 children single-handedly, and encouraged me that I could do anything in this world. And I thank you, Mama. Diana Sands, Lloyd Richards, Harold Scott, are names you may not know, but they inspired me all my days. I want to thank Bartlett Scherr. Bartlett, if you, any actors here, if you get a chance to work with this man, don't do it. No, he's wonderful, wonderful. I want to thank Bernie Gersten and Andre Bishop for making Lincoln Center a terrific place to work for. And Bart, gosh, thank you, Bart. Thank you for your trust and your respect and your love for this work. Thank you, August Wilson, for writing this wonderful play. And please wrap up. And thank you, Matthew Maloney, the electrician head who said I would win and said Obama was coming to see us before we even knew. Thank you, thank you.
Coming up, performances from Shrek the Musical, Mamma Mia, West Side Story, and presentations by Jeff Daniels, James Gandolfini, and Will Ferrell when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. The 63rd Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by the Cadillac CTS and by Downy. It's a beautiful feeling. Time in a swamp on the outskirts of Duloc, we find Donkey, Fiona, and Shrek.
Look, look, Princess, Lord Farquaad's castle.
It's a bit much, isn't it? Do you think he might be compensating for something? Oh, forget it.
So tell me about my groom-to-be, Lord Farquaad. What's he like?
Well, let me put it this way, Princess. Men of Farquaad's stature are in short supply.
Really?
Yeah, but he is a little intimidating.
Well, he must be.
And yet very good at small talk.
What are you guys doing?
What you're saying, you might want to lower your expectations a bit.
Yeah, like 3 feet or so.
All right, you're obviously jealous that you'll never measure up to a great ruler like Lord Farquaad.
Oh, we'll let you do the measuring when you meet him.
And here's the man who made it happen.
What a terrific surprise. Once upon a time, this place was infested. Freaks on every corner. I had them all arrested. Hey, nanny, 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 no. And so... things are looking up here in Duloc.
Let's take a look.
The things I'm cooking up here in Duloc.
He likes the cook.
A model that amazes. A plan with seven phases. Things are looking up here in Duloc.
They're looking up
in Duloc. An open from the gutter in Duloc.
He's taking aim.
Embrace the cookie cutter in Duloc.
We're all the same.
The upshot is enormous when you can shout. Yes,
things are
for those Duloc dancers. Aren't they terrific, huh? Ha! Ooh. Oh. Wow! Come on! Ha! Ha! Ooh. Oh. Boys!
That the cast of Shrek, one of the Tony nominated shows tonight for best musical. Wow, cool. Broadway bigger than ever. You just heard President Obama and his wife came to see a Broadway show last week. They saw Joe Turner's Come and Gone a couple weeks ago. Huge for that show. Now I know a lot of producers are here in the audience tonight, so take my advice, cash in, go presidential. I can see the marquees now. Barack of Ages. The Phantom of the Opera. She's almost the president. She's almost like kind of like Obama Mia. Thank you. Think about it. Just think about it. Thank me later. And BTW, if the president can turn off his cell phone for 2 hours, so can the moron in seat J14. I'm just saying, you at home, shut off the phone. I digress. Our next presenters are two fantastic actors who are both nominated for the same award tonight. Enjoy the tension. Ladies and gentlemen, from God of Carnage, Jeff Daniels and James Gandolfini.
For the record, Shrek and I are no relation.
It's been said that the best acting is invisible when the performers create human events on stage. These five superb nominees have done more than that. They've created some of the most memorable moments of the season.
They've also been recognized by their peers with nominations for their outstanding performances.
The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actress in a Play are Hallie Foote in Dividing the Estate,
Jessica Hines in The Norman Conquests,
Marin Ireland in The Reasons to Be Pretty,
Angela Lansbury in Blythe Spirit,
and Amanda Root in The Norman Conquests.
And the Tony Award goes to Angela Lansbury.
Tonight, the legendary Angela Lansbury becomes only the second actress in history to earn five Tony Awards.
This is amazing. Oh, my God. At this time in my life that I should be presented with this lovely, lovely award. I feel deeply grateful. I can't believe that I'm standing here. And well, because I am standing here, and some of you are sitting there, I must take this moment to send my love and my congratulations to the other nominees in this category. It wasn't fair. Bless you all. Thank you to all of my co-stars in Blythe Spirit, our producer, Jeff Richards, everybody in concern. They said at the party for the Tonys, don't talk about anybody, just say how you feel. Well, you know how I feel. I am the essence of gratitude and happiness and joy, and being back on Broadway and being with all you Broadwayites is the greatest gift in my old age that I can possibly imagine. Thank you for having me back.
Okay, so each year, members of the Broadway League bring productions of hit Broadway shows to as many as 250 theaters in 150 cities in the U.S. and Canada. Now, currently, 20 shows, including A Chorus Line, Spamalot, Avenue Q, Mary Poppins, and Wicked, are touring North America. Tonight, we're presenting three that are thrilling audiences across the country. Right now, please welcome the national touring company of the long-running hit that was nominated for five Tonys, including Best Musical, Mamma Mia.
Yeah.
right after this. We got Will Ferrell, Elton John, performances from West Side Story and Rock of Ages and more here on CBS. Don't go anywhere.
Of West Side Story performs when the 63rd annual Tony Awards continues on CBS.
All right, welcome back. Welcome back. Okay, here's another tip for you Broadway producers. Smell-o-vision. Remember that? Remember that in the 60s? You'd go to the movies, they'd give you this card. You could scratch different areas during the performance. You could smell what was happening on the screen. I took the liberty of making up a sample Broadway scratch and sniff. Let's see what Mary Poppins smells like. Strangely, I like that smell. What? I'm not gonna scratch Billy Elliot. It's outrageous. Okay, throughout the night, we'll be giving you a sample of the productions nominated for Best Play, as we honor the incredibly talented playwrights who crafted them. Now, first up, from 33 Variations, an actor who made his first-rate Broadway debut, along with an actress I shared my first on-screen kiss with. True story. Ladies and gentlemen, Colin Hanks and Samantha Mathis.
33 Variations, written and directed by Tony nominee Moises Kaufman, is a play about parenthood, passion, and the moments of beauty that can transform a life. Drama, memory, and music combine to transport the audience from present-day New York to 19th century Austria.
Though separated by 200 years, a composer coming to terms with his genius and a mother coming to terms with her daughter share an obsession that might, even just for an instant, make time stand still.
Because Mozart composed in his head, Beethoven composed on paper. So there are thousands and thousands of sketches with his every thought, every compositional idea. And they're in bond. It's the only hope I have to understand why he did it.
Please welcome an actor, writer, and producer whose show is Tony nominated tonight for Best Special Theatrical Event, Will Ferrell.
Thank you. As a Broadway veteran who spent as many as 18 previews and 46 exhausting performances trotting the boards, I've gained so much theatrical wisdom. For example, when I think of American classics, I think of Waiting for Godot. A French play written by an Irishman that's been pronounced incorrectly for 50 years. And when they asked me to present Best Score, I immediately thought of the cast of Hair. That is going to be one naked, smoke-filled cast party, that's for sure. And you know what smoke I'm talking about. But according to the list in Playbill, it's a revival, so they're not nominated for that. Earlier tonight, the Tony for Best Book of a Musical went to Lee Hall for Billy Elliot, the Musical. The nominees for Best Original Score, Music and or Lyrics Written for the Theater are Billy Elliot, the Musical, music by Elton John, lyrics by Lee Hall. Next to Normal, music by Tom Kitt, lyrics by Brian Yorkey. 9 to 5, The Musical, music and lyrics by Dolly Parton. Shrek, the Musical, music by Janine Tesori, lyrics by David Lindsay Aber. And the Tony Award goes to Next to Normal, music by Tom Kitt, lyrics by Brian Yorkey.
This is composer Tom Kitt's second Tony of the night. Having won earlier for Best Orchestrations, he shares this honor with writer and lyricist Brian Yorkey, who also takes home his first ever Tony Award.
Thank you. First of all, we are truly humbled to even be in the same breath with our heroes, Dolly Parton, Sir Elton John, Lee Hall, David Lindsay-Barron, Jeanine Tesori, whose work has inspired us to become writers in the first place.
For all those of you in this room and out there in America who are crazy enough to attempt something like an original musical, we salute you. And for what it's worth, two things we've learned. First, if you're working on something you believe in, keep going no matter how long it takes.
And second, find people who believe in it as much as you do and stand by you. We have an incredible team led by our fearless, committed, resourceful lead producer, David Stone, and his group with Patrick Cotullo, Barbara Whitman, James Erlander Jr., second stage with Ellen Richard, and Carol Rothman, and Chris Burney.
Thank you.
Writers need a chance to work, and we were so blessed to be supported by Molly Smith and David Dower at Arena Stage, Rob Hunt, Steve Tompkins, Village Theater in Issaquah, Washington, by NIMF, by the Jonathan Larson Foundation, and by the great BMI Workshop.
I want to personally thank John Bizzetti, our fiery agent and friend. I want to thank my parents, my wife, Rita, for our beautiful...
Welcome last year's Tony winner for Best Original Score, Lin-Manuel Miranda.
Tom Kitt! This season, it was my privilege to collaborate with Stephen Sondheim on the Spanish language lyrics for the first nominee for Best Revival of a Musical, West Side Story. In this bilingual production, the story is the same, but this time when the Puerto Ricans rumble, they do it in Espanol. In this number, Maria looks forward to the beginning of her new life in America at a dance at the gym, where she and Tony are first drawn to each other. Here's the company from West Side Story.
I knew something never before was gonna happen. Had to happen, but this is
My hands are cold. Yours too. So warm.
Yours too.
But of course, they are the same.
It's so much to believe. You're not joking me.
I have not yet learned how to joke that way. I think now I never will.
For
Susan Sarandon and Lauren Graham, plus performances from Rock of Ages and Guys and Dolls when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Please welcome an Academy Award-winning actress currently on Broadway in Exit the King, Susan Sarandon.
Thank you. Directors possess an incredible talent for guiding all of the elements of a production. The playwright's words into moments that are lived and relived on stage 8 times a week, driven by passion and vision. They're the ones who get blamed by the critics if all goes wrong, not necessarily my reviews, but most of the time. And the ones who don't get enough credit when the result is flawless, until this moment. The nominees for Best Direction of a Play are Phyllida Lloyd for Mary Stuart, Bartlett Sher for Joe Turner's Come and Gone, Matthew Warchus for God of Carnage, and the other Matthew Warchus for The Norman Conquests. And the Tony Award goes to the second Matthew Warchus for God of Carnage.
With 3 prior nominations for directing plays on Broadway, tonight marks the first Tony Award win for Matthew Warchus.
I was hoping for another tie, actually. Anyway, so thank you very much. This is the 4th Yasmina Reza play I've been lucky enough to direct, and all of them what you might call surprisingly big, small plays. Concise, intense, beautiful, melancholic, and hilarious pieces of work. Don't let anyone tell you, by the way, that I or Christopher Hampton have grafted or superimposed anything onto Yasmina's writing. She's a writer of great precision and audacity, a great comic observer of life, and we all work very, very hard to live up to her brilliant ideas. So thank you. Thank you for a brilliant cast. I love them all. They're completely superb and gorgeous, all of them. And while I'm up here, I've got to do it. I've got to acknowledge the Norman Conquest Company, who are also another brilliant ensemble doing terrific work at the theatre. Thank you also to Lauren Ward. She is my wife. She's been at home in London while I've been busy on Broadway, and because she has maintained calm and harmony back home, I've been able to manufacture marital mayhem on stage here in New York. Thank you very much.
Well done. Now to women and men who have masterminded the productions in which the performers sing, sometimes dance, and even soar. For Best Direction of a Musical, the nominees are Stephen Daldry for Billy Elliot the Musical, Michael Greif for Next to Normal. Kristin Hanji for Rock of Ages. And Diane Paulus for Hair. And the American Theater Wing's Tony Award goes to Stephen Daldry for Billy Elliot the Musical.
Stephen Daldry takes home his second Tony Award for directing. He won in 1994 for An Inspector Calls.
I have been blessed in my life to spend the majority of the last 10 years of my life working on the story of Billy Elliot. And in that very long, extraordinary journey, I've been working with a group of people who are more than just collaborators. They are my friends and my family. Elton John, Lee Hall, Ian McNeil, Rick Fisher, Julian Weber, Paul Arditi, Rick Fisher. Did I say that already? Martin, there's so many people who've made up this award that I'm standing here for, and it really does belong to them, as it does belong to our wonderful cast who are here today, led by the incomparable Greg Jabaran, Hayden Gwynn, and Carol Shelley, and our unbelievably talented children. And also our crew down at the Imperial Theatre. An amazing crew and stage managers who keep the show alive. And perhaps more than anything else, it belongs to three, if you like, three great gifts of Broadway, our three little Billies. So this is for them. This is for us. Thank you very much indeed.
Showstopper. That irrepressible love story. Look at this one. She's practically begging for it, aren't you? You nasty little Tony nominated freak machine. Now, where was I? Well, for that, we should probably cue piano.
Just a city boy, born and raised in. right after this on CBS.
A performance from Guys and Dolls is next when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards continues on CBS. Gentlemen, please welcome Edie Falco.
The most memorable Broadway experiences are special, theatrical, and always an event. Like the nominees for this next award. They were all limited engagements, so you can put away your credit cards. For Best Special Theatrical Event, the nominees are
Liza's at the Palace, Slava Snow Show, Soul of Shaolin, You're Welcome America, A Final Night with George W. Bush.
And the Tony Award goes to Liza's at the Palace.
Accepting the award for Liza's at the Palace, producer John Scher.
I'm going to be real quick, try to thank some of the people from behind the scenes. First of all, Gary Labriola, who co-produced the show with us and been with Liza for many years, fantastic. My partner Al Cafaro, Diana Guthrie, Ian Noble, Brian O'Boyle, Scott Campbell, Dana Wise, Howard Brooks, Nadine Dunn, Manny Kladitis, our general manager, and Petrina, Peter Cromedy, our great PR guy, Alan Arrow, the Needlelander organization, and of course my wife, Sherry, and my two daughters, Carly and Jamie. And let me say just one other thing. This was truly an honor to be able to present a great American treasure on Broadway, Liza Minnelli.
I can't tell you, this is exquisite. Listen, I want to thank my crew and my orchestra. I want to thank my wonderful boys, Tiger Martina, Cortez Alexander. help me. I didn't want to use this because I didn't think I was going to win, so I didn't memorize it. Okay, I thought my beautiful man over there was going to win. Okay. Now, what was I going to say? Okay, wait. Okay. Cortez Alexander, Jim Caruso, Tiger Martina, Billy Stritch, who did this music. And let me tell you something. If that wasn't hard to recreate, Kay Thompson's music. And what happened was we really started out and we were nowhere. No, we were horrible. But we were the pits, but we were trying. But I believed in this, and I went and I found the one man who I knew could make all of this work, and that was our director and our choreographer, Ron Lewis. And he brought us together. Lastly, I'd like to thank, if you don't mind, my parents for the gift, the greatest gift they ever gave me, Kay Johnson.
From God of Carnage, please welcome two of tonight's Tony-nominated leading actresses, Hope Davis and Marcia Gay Harden.
Our second nominee for Best Play, God of Carnage, created by Tony-winning playwright Yasmina Reza, explores the dynamics of two seemingly civilized couples who meet in the aftermath of a playground fight.
At first, diplomatic niceties are observed, but as the meeting progresses, huge tensions emerge and the gloves come off, leaving more than just their liberal principles in tatters.
I'm sure your son is
not a savage.
Of course Benjamin isn't a savage.
Yes, he is.
Alan. Why say something like that?
He's a savage.
Well, how does he explain his behavior?
He doesn't want to discuss it.
But he ought to discuss it.
He ought to do any number of things. He ought to come here, he ought to discuss it, he ought to be sorry for it. Clearly you have parenting skills that put us to shame. We hope to improve, but in the meantime, please bear with us.
Nominated actor. She's making her Broadway debut this season in Guys and Dolls. Please welcome Oliver Platt and Lauren Graham.
Our second nominee for Best Revival of a Musical is a love letter to a time when Broadway was rampant with colorful racketeers and con men.
Some things never change. After losing a dice game in a sewer, a dozen or so gamblers make good on their bet and repent their sins in this timeless number. Please welcome our sensational castmates from Guys and Dolls.
Now, who would like to start the ball rolling by giving testimony?
It happened to me kind of funny, kind of like a dream.
Am I going in with it? I'm going.
And by some chance, I had brought my dice along. And there I stood, and I hollered, "Someone feed me!" But the passengers, they know right from wrong. For the people are set, sit down, you're rocking the boat. The people are set, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And the devil will drag you under by the sharp lapel of your checkered coat. Sit down, you're rocking the boat. I sailed away on that little boat to heaven, and by some chance found a bottle in my fist. And there I stood, nicely passing out the whiskey. But the passengers were bound to resist. For the people all said, "Beware, you're on a heavenly trip." People all said, "Beware, beware, you'll scuttle the ship." And the devil will drag you under by the fancy tie on your wicked throat. Sit down, you're rocking the boat. And as I laughed at those passengers to heaven, a great big wave came and washed me overboard. And as I sank and I hollered, "Someone save me!" That's the moment I woke up. Thank the Lord. And I said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. Said to myself, sit down, you're rocking the boat. And the devil will drag you under.
Yeah!
Coming up, performances from Jersey Boys and Hair. Plus, this actor starred in his high school production of Our Town. Find out who he is as he presents two Tony Awards when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Performance from Next to Normal is next when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards continues on CBS. Earlier tonight, a number of Tony Awards were presented, including the Regional Theater Tony, which went to the Signature Theater of Arlington, Virginia.
One thing that's never really changed is the work that we've done has always been about the passion and really the creativity.
And the Tony goes to... This gets us off to an exciting start. We have a tie.
Tom and I would like to thank our music director, Charlie Alterman, and the terrific band.
Well, thank you very much indeed. This is very, very special to me. I'd like to start off by thanking Elton John for writing this fantastic score in the first place.
For me, Billy Elliot's about me and my dad, who I lost earlier than the year.
I want to thank the incredible company in New York. I want to thank the enormously talented children in New York.
Please welcome Lucie Arnaz and Kate Burton.
Kate and I both have the great privilege of serving on the board of directors of the American Theater Wing.
The Wing has always been more than the Tonys, and one of its signature programs, Working in the Theater, marks its 30th anniversary this year.
It's a fascinating program, and it's created this priceless archive of information on the craft of making great theater. And, you know, we were lucky, like Liza. We grew up in show business families, and listening to the shop talk, you know, between our parents and their peers in the industry was such an invaluable tool for learning professionally and personally as well.
Working in the Theater offers a rare opportunity for students, aspiring professionals, and interested audience members to see the people who create theater discussing their art in a similar fashion. This unprecedented forum brings together performers, directors, playwrights, plus all of the creative and technical personnel for informative conversations on the craft of making theater. With more than 900 past guests, Working in the Theater has become an unequaled archive of audio and video that's available free and on demand from our website, along with information about the Wing's many other activities.
So on behalf of our chairman, Ted Chapin, and the rest of the board and staff of the Wing, we're happy to have you joining us for this celebration of the Tony Awards that we present each year with the Broadway League. And maybe one day, who knows, we might see one of you up here on stage at the Tonys. Yeah!
Please welcome an actor who returns to Broadway this fall in Bye Bye Birdie, John Stamos.
Thank you. Yes, that was a picture of me earlier as Barry Gibb in Our Town, the disco musical. Look at that. I thought George should have a snap-on beard. The mark of a great musical actor is the ability to create emotion and recreate it every night, twice on matinee days, singing and dancing. For one of these five wonderfully gifted gentlemen, there may be some dancing, but the emotions you're about to see won't be acting. The nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actor in a Musical are David Bologna, Billy Elliot the Musical. Gregory Jabara, Billy Elliot the Musical. Mark Kudish, 9 to 5 the Musical. Christopher Sieber, Shrek the Musical. And Will Swenson, Hair. And the American Theater Wing's Tony goes to Gregory Jabara, Billy Elliot, the Musical.
Gregory Jabara earns his first Tony playing the part of Billy Elliot's dad in Billy Elliot, the Musical.
The
This is my wife, Julie, who has spent the majority of the last year as a single parent raising our sons in Los Angeles so that I could have this opportunity here tonight. Zachary and Aiden, I hope you're wearing your bow ties. Thanks for being such a good supporter of Daddy. I'm dedicating this award to four men who can't be here because they're no longer with us on this plane. My father, John Jabara, a person who was a fly on the wall at my Juilliard audition, Frank Donnelly, my first agent, Brian Reardon, and James Raitt, who championed me into my very first Broadway musical of Damn Yankees. You're going to hear a lot of people mentioned from our show tonight, so I'm going to bring up some names you aren't going to hear, and that is Tommy Batchelor, Tanner Pfluger, and Frank Dolce. Thank you, Julian and Stephen. I am so honored. Thank you, American Theater Wing. This is the best.
And now the nominees for Best Performance by a Featured Actress in a Musical are Jennifer Damiano, Next to Normal, Hayden Gwynn, Billy Elliot the Musical, Karen Olivo, West Side Story, Martha Plimpton from Pal Joey, and Carol Shelley, Billy Elliot the Musical. And the Tony Award goes to Karen Olivo, West Side Story.
Karen Olivo wins her first Tony Award for her spectacular performance as Anita in the revival of West Side Story.
Completely unprepared for this. I have to say, thank you, Arthur, for believing in me and giving me confidence when I never had confidence. My husband, who's amazing, and I can't do anything without. The amazing cast, Josefina Scaglione, you make it so easy to be Anita. And George Akram, thank you. Thank you for carrying me around the stage night after night. Oh my God, I just want to dedicate this to everyone who has a dream. And a lot of people said I couldn't do this, and I think that if you stick with it and you surround yourself with people who love you, you can do anything. I'm sorry. Thank you.
Please welcome an actress and playwright who will return to Broadway later this year in her autobiographical story, Wishful Drinking, Carrie.
Hi there.
Thank you.
Our third nominee for Best Musical, Next to Normal, is about one woman's struggle with manic depression and the toll it takes on her family. Next to Normal's surging score tells the intense, emotional, and ultimately hopeful story of how a family comes to terms with their past and faces their future. This song finds Diana arguing with her husband about her course of treatment in her mania. She imagines that her son comes to her rescue and that he and her husband fight for Diana's attention and devotion. Please welcome from the cast of Next to Normal, the cast from Next to Normal.
Diana, look, I know this is hard.
Really? What exactly do you know?
I know that you're hurting. I am too.
Do you wake up in the morning and need help to lift your head? Do you read obituaries and feel jealous of the dead?
Sure.
intuition that you're screaming, but you never make a sound. Or the feeling that you're falling, but you never hit the ground. It just keeps on rushing at you, day by day by day by day. You don't know what it's like to live that way. Like a refugee, a fugitive, forever on the run. If it gets me, don't kill me, but I don't know what I've done.
Can you tell me what it is you're afraid of? Can you tell me why I'm afraid it's me? Can I touch you? We've been fighting for so long now. How could something go wrong that I can't see? 'Cause I'm holding.
From Legally Blonde, Hair, and Billy Elliot. Plus, this actor appeared in his college production of The Bald Soprano. Find out who he is as he presents the Tony for Leading Actress in a Play when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. The 63rd Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Kia. Now during Kia's 15-year celebration, we're rolling back prices on select 09 models. For details, visit Kia.com. And by Orencia.
Oh, sorry. I was just having some sushi. This stuff is great. I have, like, so much energy. Like, if I ate this all the time, I could do show after show, just night after night. It would be... Sorry. Our next presenter has done pretty much everything there is to do in entertainment. Movies, Broadway, me. Please welcome two-time Academy Award winner, Jessica Lange.
Actually, I've never met him. The artists nominated for Best Performance by a Lead Actor in a Play have brought an emotional commitment and passion toward their characters and the playwright's words. These superb nominees have created some of the finest moments on stage this season. They are Jeff Daniels in God of Carnage. Raul Esparza in Speed the Plow. James Gandolfini in God of Carnage. Jeffrey Rush in Exit the King. Thomas Sadowski in Reasons to be Pretty. And the American Theater Wing's Tony Award goes to Jeffrey Rush, Exit the King.
A veteran actor of stage, screen, and television, tonight Jeffrey Rush wins his first Tony Award.
The best thing tonight was being a little light among 6,000. The season on Broadway this year for me has been exactly that. I want to thank the American Theatre Wing. I want to thank Manhattan audiences for proving that French existential absurdist tragicomedy rocks. We live in slightly fragile, uncertain times. I think French existential absurdist tragicomedy is reflected in any play that's on. My colleagues, Raoul Esparza in Speed the Plow by David Mamet. James Gandolfini and Jeff Daniels in God of Carnage by Yasmina Reza. And Thomas Sadowski in Les Raisons pour être jolie by Neil Labute. Thank you to everyone at the Barrymore cast, crew, backstage, company management. Thank you to everyone at Belvoir and Malthouse, where this play originated in Sydney and Melbourne. Hello, Federation Square. Thank you, Neil Ski, 29 years of working in the theatre together. And thank you, Jane, Angelica, and James, for giving me the pleasure of being here and enduring our absence. Thank you so much.
From the Broadway production of Dividing the Estate, currently at Hartford Stage, please welcome Gerald McCraney and Tony-nominated featured actress Hallie Foote.
Our third nominee for Best Play, Dividing the Estate, was written by my father, two-time Academy Award winner and Tony nominee, Horton Foote. A chronicle of small-town life, this human comedy centers around a Texas family, revealing the challenges they face as they must confront their past and prepare for their future.
Set during the oil bust of the 1980s, even the power of petty self-interest and long-held resentments can't talk this family matriarch into dividing the estate.
He has not earned a red cent in 4 months.
Well, why didn't you just say so? The estate will loan you money.
I don't want the estate to loan me anything. I want us to divide the estate so I can have a little dignity in my life.
Please welcome two-time Tony-winning actress, B.B. Newer.
Tony-winning actress Natasha Richardson offered an observation on the importance of enjoying one's life. To stop dreaming and do it, because so many people have died before their time. Traditionally, we pause to remember the cherished members of our community who, like Natasha, are no longer with us. This year, we lost some giants, including the chairman of the Schubert Organization, Gerald Schoenfeld. Jerry is credited with reinvigorating commercial theater as we know it by bringing dozens of hit shows to Broadway, among them Cats, Dreamgirls, Phantom of the Opera, and A Chorus Line. Here are the Broadway inspirational voices with a song that will forever be associated with Jerry's legacy and passion of our colleagues.
From Billy Elliot the Musical is next when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards continues on CBS. Earlier tonight, Tony Awards for designers were presented.
In the best of times, artistic creation doesn't involve ego. I feel that this production of August Wilson's masterpiece is an example of that phenomena.
I just want to encourage all of you to keep bringing little kids to the theater because we'll be here. Thank you.
I always think that the best part of designing for theater and film is that call that you get saying you've got the job. From there on in, it's usually pretty much a nightmare.
I feel very, very lucky to be a part of this community, and even more lucky to be a part of this amazing season.
I'd like to thank my associate, Paul Atkinson, who's a very kind, patient, and wildly talented man. Who I've known for years.
This is enormously generous, although it does, of course, give me an enormous problem because I now have to tell my parents that I don't actually work in a bank.
Ladies and gentlemen, there's no greater honor for a theater sound designer than to win a Tony Award. I'm deeply grateful.
Not only is our next presenter an Academy Award nominee, he's also the handsome lad in that photo you saw just before the break from his college production of The Bald Soprano. Please welcome the three-time Tony Award-winning Frank Langella.
I must say, it's wonderful to be here on a night when the Broadway community gathers to support and honor each other. I don't know about the rest of you, but award season always brings out the best in me. And I'm certain it brings out the best in the nominating committee as well. I'm sure they won't mind if I remind them that I did appear on Broadway this season. Oh, no, it's too late. It's too late. I think they must have all been out of town in our 4 month sold-out run of A Man for All Seasons in September, October, November, and December. Thank you. It's easy to see why they might have missed us. The Roundabout Theater did take an ad for me. And I think I have it somewhere here. Wait a second. Oh, no, that's my Oscar acceptance speech. Is that it? Oh, here it is. Yes, it's entirely possible that they missed it because, you know, it would be easy not to notice it. You know what I think? Anyway, I would like them to know I don't hold any grudges against them. And I thought Jeffrey Rush was nice in that play. Now, I'm sure there are 5 women in the audience who have not heard one single word I've said in the last 2 minutes. So I'm going to get down to telling you the names of the chosen few. And wonderful they all are. The nominees for Best Performance by an Actress in a Leading Role are Hope Davis, God of Carnage. Jane Fonda, 33 Variations. Marcia Gay Harden, God of Carnage. Janet McTeer, Mary Stewart. And Harriet Walker, Mary Stewart. I apologize, that is Harriet Walter, Mary Stewart. And the Tony goes to Marcia Gay Harden.
Tonight, Marcia Gay Harden earns her first Tony Award. She was previously nominated in 1993 for Angels in America, Millennium Approaches.
Thank you. What a glorious season to be on Broadway. I tell my kids every day that bad behavior and hysteria and tantrums and tears will get them nowhere. I don't quite know how to explain this. I've seen the beautiful performances of Janet and Harriet. For our viewing audiences, they were mixed up. Harriet has beautiful brown hair and Janet beautiful blonde hair. And Jane Fonda, and I have the joy of performing every night with my friend, the divine Hope. So I am all the more humbled and honored and thrilled to have this prestigious award. Thank you, Tony voters. As many of you know, the play is about marital strife. So I should probably start by thanking my husband, Thaddeus Scheel, for preparing me so well for the role in our many dress rehearsals. Thank you, Thaddeus. How do I feel? I feel like I've been given a custody of a baby that has 4 parents, 4 sick, deranged parents, but nonetheless, I do share this with James Gandolfini, who brings out the worst in me every night. Thank you, James, and Jeff Daniels, the suave, and the gorgeous Hope Davis, thank you. It's a pleasure fighting with you guys every night. This play springs from the brilliant mind of Yasmina Reza, and it was translated by Chris Hampton, thank you. But Matthew Warchus, without your sublime direction, we would have sent this play out to pasture long ago with all the milking for laughs. So thank you for your love of human foibles. To my family, I love you. And Mom, thank you for helping me lug the suitcase up so many flights when I first came to New York. I love you all.
Welcome two versatile performers making their Broadway debuts this season in Reasons to be Pretty. Piper Perabo and Stephen Pasquale.
Our third nominee for Best Play marks the long-awaited Broadway debut of playwright Neil LaBute, who has created a love story about the impossibility of love. A tight circle of four friends is thrown into turmoil when a man who truly adores his girlfriend reveals his true thoughts about her physical imperfections.
Their relationships crumble, and the four friends are forced to confront a sea of deceit, infidelity, and betrayal. As this hopelessly romantic comedy drama reveals the hopelessness of romance.
No, what I said was, I know what I said now, this is it. I said this. Yeah, well, maybe Steph hasn't got a face like that girl. Maybe her face is just regular, but I wouldn't trade her for $1 million, you know, something like that.
Please welcome Sir Elton John.
Thank you. At its heart, Billy Elliot is about a child's emotional struggle for the right to dance and a community's economic struggle for its right to work. At this point in the story, both these crises have come to a head. Billy's dad has just told him he can't go to ballet school, while the local mining community, its lives are up in arms because they are erupting in a war with the police. This is young Billy's reaction.
Mum would have let us.
Your mum's dead, Billy.
Coming up, Angela Lansbury, Anne Hathaway, David Hyde Pierce, and performances from Legally Blonde, Hair, and Jersey Boys when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards returns on CBS. Welcome an actress who returns to Broadway this fall in Bye Bye Birdie, Gina Gershon.
This season, 43 new productions opened on Broadway. And theatergoers made this the highest grossing season in the history of the Broadway League. A blonde myself, I can totally appreciate this next Broadway League show, which earned 7 Tony nominations and is currently selling out theaters across the country. Legally Blonde.
Maybe she's what you prefer, but hey, last year I was her. Maybe you will change your mind, but you might look up to find I've gone on to better things, better jobs or bigger rings. I don't have the time to cry, I'm too busy loving my name. Up on that list, kind of a cool ironic twist. Who else can I tell? Oh wait, where's my cell? Mama fall on the floor. Hey mom, look at my name in black and white. Your daughter's doing something fine. I feel so much better.
Who's had his shows revived, I can tell you that it's a thrill when audiences discover your work anew. It's a compliment only eclipsed by someone says, your skin looks so young. Is it collagen or are you just gaining weight? Tonight's nominees for best revival of a face, I mean a play, are...
Joe Turner's Come and Gone. Mary Stewart. The Norman Conquests. Waiting for Godot.
And the Tony Award goes to The Norman Conquests.
Accepting the award for The Norman Conquests, producer Sonia Friedman.
Producers that put this show on. This production came from the Old Vic, and I first... Oh, my God.
Sorry.
Okay. I've heard this is what happens. Come forward, the actors, please, the cast of Norman Conquest. I'm simply the spokesperson here. This award really goes to... 3 or 4 people. First and foremost, Alan Ayckbourn, who is a genius. I'm so honoured to be holding this on his behalf. To Matthew Waters, who's the man of the moment. He's extraordinary. He's directed 3 plays absolutely superbly. And these actors here, Amanda, Stephen, Ben, Paul, come forward, please. Jessica and Amelia. They are every night doing something quite exquisite. I'm very, very proud to be part of this production. And finally, thank you all, these very many brilliant producers who had the courage to back this when no one else would. Thank you so much.
Throughout the night, you've heard about this year's nominees for Best Play from some of the brilliant actors who brought them to life on stage. Once again, the nominees are...
Dividing the Estate. God of Carnage. Reasons to be Pretty. 33 Variations.
And the awards.
And the American Theater Wing's Tony Award goes to God of Carnage.
Accepting the award for God of Carnage, author Yasmina Reza and producer Robert Fox.
Thank you very much to the American Wing. Thank you everyone who's voted for us. I've got a wonderful company of actors. I'm just one of the producers. As you can see, there are others, beautiful, all of them. And what a cast. They are the acting equivalent of Roger Federer. But without the writer, there would be nothing, and we have the best. And I want you to welcome Yasmina.
Thank you very much. I'm very happy to be here again. Maybe you missed my accent. You wanted to hear it again. I am very grateful for all the people who gave their best for the production. And I share this award with my dearest Christopher and Matthew Watchers. And also I dedicate it to my mother, who overcame her fear of flying to be with us tonight. Thank you too much.
A performance from Hair is next when the 63rd Annual Tony Awards continues on CBS. Please welcome five-time Tony winner, Angela Lansbury.
I'd like to introduce you to the life's work of one of my dearest friends.
This is Jerry Herman, the youngest composer lyricist on Broadway, creator of the score for the current smash hit Hello Dolly, winner of the Tony Award in 1964 as Best Musical.
I didn't want to write another title song after Hello Dolly, because I kept on saying to the producers, it's never going to happen a second time. Lightning does not strike twice.
Before the parade passes by, I've got to get some life back into my life.
It's a time for a great merry and fun.
I won't send roses or hold the door. I won't remember which dress you wore.
Time heals everything, April, August. If I'm patient, the break will mend.
It was more than a play. It was a social moment in America.
That are like him, bouncy, buoyant, and optimistic. That innate optimism has allowed him to express himself honestly, reminding us that it only takes a moment. Open a new window and tap out your troubles before the parade passes by, because the best of times is now. It's today. It's my enormous pleasure to present the special Tony Award for Lifetime Achievement to a man who's never been afraid to say, I am what I am, Jerry Herman.
Oh, my God. Thank you, thank you. It just doesn't get any better than this, does it? Did you know that I was born on this street and that my mother thought there was something special about the fact that her hospital window had a great view of the Winter Garden Marquee? Well, here I am, 77 years later. Still on 50th Street. But enjoying the ultimate moment of my life. The journey from Mom's window to this iconic stage has been filled with so much joy and excitement and laughter and lifelong friendships that the only way I know how to say thank you to the hundreds of thousands of people who helped get me here is to say one enormous, heartfelt thank you to every soul who has touched my life in the musical theater. The thing I want you to know is that I will hold this moment fast, because the best of times is now, is definitely now.
Please welcome an actress who returns to the New York stage this week in Central Park in the Public Theater's production of Shakespeare's 12th Night. Most men would give anything for just one of those nights. Please welcome Anne Hathaway.
Thank you, thank you. Hello, Radio City Music Hall. Thank you. As we end enter a new chapter in our nation's history, the public theater's production of a powerful and controversial show about the turbulent 1960s returns to Broadway. Its questioning of authority and message of hope urge us to accept the idea that if you change your life, you can change the world. With our next nominee for Best Revival of a Musical, please welcome The Company of Hair.
She asks me why I'm just a hairy guy. I'm hairy noon and night. Hair, that's a fright. I'm hairy high and low. Don't ask me why.
Don't know.
It's not for lack of bread, like the Grateful Dead.
Darling,
give me a head with hair, long, beautiful hair, shining, gleaming, steaming, flaxen, waxen. Give me a down to there, hair, shoulder length no longer. Here, baby, there, mama, everywhere, daddy, daddy, hair.
Clothes on and everything. You've seen performances from the companies of three productions nominated for Best Revival of a Musical, plus nominee Stockard Channing from Pal Joey, which was a limited engagement, much like most of my relationships. Once again, the nominees are
Guys and Dolls, Hair,
pal Joey. West Side Story.
And the Tony Award goes to Hair.
Accepting the award for Hair, producer Oscar Eustace.
Richards, Jerry Frankel, Andy Hammingson, Jenny Gersten, Joey Parnes, Liz McCann, and this amazing tribe around me. The authors, Galt McDermott, Jim Rado, Jerry Ragney, the incredible Diane Paulus and her team that put together a production with these 32 most beautiful beasts of the forest. The tribe who not only believe in what Hair stands for, they live it every day. I have to thank my kids, Jack and Kyle, the 33rd member of the tribe. My wife, Lori, my part of this award belongs to her, as does everything I make, everything I own, everything I am. But most of all, I want to also thank Warren Spector and the amazing board and Andy Hammingson and the tireless staff of the Public Theater of New York. It's the theater that Joe Papp and Bernie Gersten founded 55 years ago with a very simple idea that if the theater was going to matter, it had to be a theater for the people, and it had to talk about the things that mattered to the people. Peace now, freedom now, equality now, justice forever. Thank you.
Who's currently starring on Broadway in Accent on Youth. Coming out for the second time this month, David Hyde Pierce.
A sophisticated socialite, an ogress with attitude, a lovelorn Latina, a woman in the midst of a nervous breakdown, and a working girl not to be trifled with. Yes, I've been called a lot of things. But tonight, I'm a proud presenter. The extraordinary nominees for Best Performance by a Leading Actress in a Musical are Stockard Channing for Pal Joey, Sutton Foster for Shrek the Musical, Allison Janney, 9 to 5, the musical, Alice Ripley, Next to Normal, Josefina Scaglione for West Side Story, and the American Theatre Wing's Tony Award goes to Alice Ripley.
Wins her first Tony Award for her passionate performance as Diana.
There's a quote in the Kennedy Center by John Fitzgerald Kennedy, and it says, I am certain that after the dust of centuries has passed over our cities, we too will be remembered not for our victories or defeats in battle or in politics, but for our contribution to the human spirit. And he's talking about art. He's talking about art when he says that. And so tonight, I am just stunned and honored beyond belief to be here with my family, Mom, Dad, Dee, Rick, Cindy, Scott, Kim, Tina, and Laura, Dan, Rob, and Cal, and my mother, and and all my friends on and off stage here tonight to accept this award is just beyond my wildest dreams. And I have to say something about art, because I think that Next to Normal fits the category of things that he was talking about here. And what that is to me is, my degree from college is a BFA, it's a fine art. Musical theater is a fine art, and so it needs constant adjusting and constant tuning. Michael Greif, David Stone, Tom Kidd, Brian Yorkie, you all led the show to that end result of it being a fine art, and I am so honored to be a part of the show. Everybody knows that I thank them, because I've been thanking them all week. So good night, everybody. Enjoy the rest of the evening. Thank you so much.
Welcome, four-time Tony winner, Audra McDonald.
I was supposed to say, oh, yes, that's a picture of me dreaming of performing on Broadway, but I'm not up there. Oh, yes. Performing on Broadway just about 3 months ago, dreaming about that. The nominees for Best Performance by Leading Actor in a Musical. This year, for the first time, a trio of performers shares a single nomination for their performances in one role. The nominees are Kirill Kulish, Trent Kowalik, and David Alvarez in Billy Elliot the Musical. Gavin Creel, Hair. Brian D'Arcy James in Shrek the Musical. Constantine Maroulis, Rock of Ages. J. Robert Spencer in Next to Normal, and the Tony Award goes to David Alvarez, Trent Kowalik, and Kirill Kulish, Billy Elliot.
The Tony Award has been shared by three people. Congratulations to David, Trent, and Kirill for making Tony's history in their Broadway debuts.
Wow. This is quite unbelievable.
Okay. Well, we've got so many people to thank. We have
okay, we have Julian, of course, Stephen, we have Peter, Kate, we have Lee, we have BT, Julian, and of course, Elton, and
people in the show, the adult company, all the children in the show, the stage managers, guardians, and our dresser, Jess.
But most of all, tonight we'd like to thank our families for the love and support.
My mom, my dad, my brother and sister.
Two sisters.
And my mom and my dad and my three sisters, Siobhan, Daria, and Kareen. And none of us would be here today if it weren't for all of our fabulous teachers we've had. There's Sean Reagan, and there's all my teachers from Dorothy School of Dance in Belmore, Long Island.
I'd like to thank Maxime and Sylvia Chernyshev at San Diego Academy of Ballet.
I'd like to thank Mr. Kevin McKenzie, 92nd Y School, Mr. Frankie DeVita, and Mr. Wayne Lucas from American Ballet Theater.
And we want to say to all the kids out there who might want to dance, never give up.
Now, an actress who makes her Broadway return tomorrow night in the Tony-winning revival of Chicago. Please welcome Chandra Wilson.
The current revival of
of Chicago isn't the only Tony-winning show that's set in a legendary locale and currently thrilling audiences across the country and around the world. Thanks to the Broadway League, we have a first. 5 Frankie Valleys on one stage from Toronto, Las Vegas, the national tour, Chicago, and Broadway. Please welcome the 2006 Tony winner for Best Musical, Jersey Boys.
Just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived, and I thank God I'm alive. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off. If you feel like I feel, please let me know that it's real. You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you.
The 63rd Annual Tony Awards are sponsored by Cadillac and by the Cadillac CTS. Please welcome 4-time Tony winner Liza Minnelli.
Thank you. And the nominees for Best Musical are Billy Elliot, the Musical. Next to North. Rock of Ages. Shrek the Musical.
Here into rock.
The Tony goes to Billy Elliot, the Musical! Yeah! Yeah!
Accepting the award for Billy Elliot, the Musical, producer Eric Fellner.
As you can see, there's a lot of excitement on the stage here.
here tonight to reiterate what the Jersey Boys were saying. What a night. On behalf of all of us here, we'd like to thank the league, the wing, and all the Tony voters for, in this incredible season, choosing to honor us, and we can't thank you enough. There are many, many people to thank along the way. It's been an incredible journey. I'd like to just pay attention to draw attention to a few people here in New York that have made our stay so enjoyable, and that is Nina Lannan and her team, Devin Cadell, John Barlow, Broadway's greatest publicist, Drew Hodges of Spotco, the Schuberts, Phil Smith, and the late, great Jerry Schoenfeld, without whom we wouldn't have a home here on Broadway. There's one person who we all owe an enormous debt of gratitude, and that's to Elton John. It was his idea that we turn the film we made into a musical, and without him we wouldn't be here.
First of all, I would really like to congratulate us, the writers, to Next to Normal. What an incredible night for you guys. May you stay together and write many more musicals and be loyal and true to each other and enjoy tonight as we are going to enjoy tonight. This is all, writing musicals is about teamwork, and without these guys, this would never have been so enjoyable. Thank you for accepting us so beautifully on Broadway. We came here at a hard time economically. You opened your wallets and you opened your hearts to us, and we love you for it. Thank you.
But this is Broadway, and all great Broadway shows have a closing number, an 11 o'clock number. And oh my gosh, look at the time. It's 11:03. So here we go.
Tonight, the Tonys were tonight, and Elton's Billy was all the rage. What class, what drive. Now Angela won five, and she hooked up with and backstage with heels as sore as poor Achilles. 3-2-2 wearing Billy's were such a winning sight. Tonight, all three won Tony, plus they hit puberty. And Jeffrey won a Tony tonight. Ripley's daughter Alice, they all won a Tony tonight. Credits, that's not gonna stop me. Chris Seaver, please, performing on your knees. Dude, that only works to win Golden Globes. I hope tonight, when they're high as a kite, to be there when the Liza was named mayor, and Elton John took flight. The curtain falls. I'm off to hit some big Tony.